Hey everyone, good morning, or afternoon, or evening, wherever it is where you're watching. Today we're going to get into the meat of a project I've been looking to do for some time now. It is the short shift kit for a 987 Cayman / Boxster, and I believe it'll also go into the 997, 911 range. So I'll show you the goodies, and we'll get to the project. To the left, you'll see the short shift kit, and that is OEM spec, purchased from Suncoast. And then on the right, we have from Flat Six Motorsports the Race Sang shift knob and 987 compatible adapter. So if you take a look here, the only other accent piece, I did put the red ring on this. I believe there were two other colors, being blue and black, I want to say. So if we do this right, we can get this thing unbuckled soon enough. We'll be putting these bad boys in, and I said bad boys again, so if any of you playing bad boy bingo at home can take another drink. A quick look at how long these throws are. So right now, we're in neutral. We'll measure from the front of the handbrake here for grins. So we'll go push it up into first. And to the R is pretty much 8 inches. And to the R, it is something in the 3 3/4 inches range. So
it is.
We'll see. We'll assume it's the same for 3rd to 4th, 8 inches. Yep. So 3 3/4. So we have 4 1/4 inches of throw. So that's our benchmark. We'll start with that, and let's get this taken off. I've seen a lot of people have fun ripping these off, so get ready for a laugh. I may bonk myself in the face. Okay, so this next situation involves removing the shift boot here. I know there's 1, 2 clips there, and I think it's 1, 2, 3 or something of the sort, but let's take it off and see. Just kind of pop it. I'm not sure where the best place to pop it is. I'll let you know when I see, but yeah, it seems like the front. So there's one here, one here, one here. So giving you a better view. Three, four, five. And now you can see the boot's clear. It looks like the boot has already kind of pulled away from the housing here. So the next step, as I understand it, is to twist something down here to release the shift knob, or so it can pull up. So let's get that underway, and I'll get you a better angle. Okay, so I did put this back together just so you could see what you won't be able to see when you're removing this. So you can see this is in the lock position right now, so the orientation will be like this. So let's flip it back up here. This is locked, and then you're flipping this little knob in the corner in order to straighten all of these guys up in order to be able to yank the gear stick off of the internal movement parts. So that hopefully helps you out with a visual. Let go, Rye. And so that was it on the right way, right way oriented. And there's your little knobby in the corner. Fun, fun, fun. Here we are on the passenger side, going down into the footwell. You can see here, this is the cigarette lighter. And right below it is this little messed up little part of the carpet, and in there is a T25 screw. and it is now gone. And you can see it's held in by two clips here as well. So there are two clips, and that reveals this and this, which we will release in order to be able to remove the center console pieces right down here, which run along here, which get us access back to the gearbox. Anyway, so that's that loose. I did loosen the other side. Let's see if we can move this a little bit. You can see a little bit of a tug just pulls loose, and it will be the same on the other side. You can see here, just need to loosen these guys up. You pull them forwards a little bit, and there's a couple of clips here that will push back down when we go to reinsert those. That's just to reveal these two, what I'm guessing are Torx 20s, and or T20s I'm supposed to say, I think. So let me see if we can get these out and continue dismantling the center console. Take off this cover. It came off by hand, but if you had to pop it off, I'm sure if you just used a prying tool, you'd be able to get it up. So that reveals this, easy to see here, just right under the handbrake, you've got this unit. So just get this guy out. Then with our, if you try. Okie dokie. So you can see here, this little plastic mat, I'd say it comes out easily as I'm making a hash of it, but there it is. And if my camera person can come in here, you'll see it reveals two more Torx, hopefully 20s, but we'll find out here in a second. Oh, the least well-attached screw of my lifetime. Let's see how the other one does. Oh yeah, two for two. Who knew? And bingo. So let's see what's under here.
Are you gonna put those back in?
So something gives me a feeling that this has been done before. Let's just disconnect this guy here so we can get at the center console. It's a pretty basic rectangular connector that was feeding the aux input there. So there was an additional screw in here, which was actually connected. So that was holding it down. So this, you can see, is loosened. This top piece, we're going to try and extract this here. Oh, and that guy came off. I wonder if that would make life easier, but not gonna fight it. So there's that top piece, trim piece. And then you can see we've exposed two further, hopefully T20s. One. Two. Put those in the bin there. And wow, we're getting to a really scary place here. Cause we just took apart another piece of the car. Built in like March of 09. Cool. All right, so you can see now, this whole unit's pretty loose. There's two screws on these front corners up here. So forgive me reaching in front. Right, can you put this in here?
Yeah.
Just put it in the hole.
You need more light.
If you can get me in the hole. Okay, that's that guy. And then whoops. That's that one. I wanna say this. Yeah. All the screws here. Oops. Well, that cable just came out. That's fine. All right, Rye, is anything attached?
Nope. Not on my side.
Oh, here's something attached. As I remove the cramp in my leg. Oh! Okay, so let's get this out. Push this. Let's see if we can detach to here the couple of connectors that should free up that. And what's under here? That's all to there.
All right. So here's the large connector in here. Connect is the last piece holding the console down. And we'll have the whole console out here. So I'm going to try and wrench this off and should be able to get this the unit out.
Give it a bit of a clean. Let's see here. Released at the back, remembering the two fake screws and the one real screw I didn't show you coming off. Going down here, plenty of screws in there. And we'll take this piece off down here, which, let's see if I can get that holding a camera without getting you seasick. I don't think I'm going to be able to. So you're just going to have to figure this part out by yourselves. But I imagine if I get two fingers on each side of that and just give it a little tug, the whole unit will come out nicely. So let's try this again. I, as you tend to do in these projects, tend to overcomplicate things. So it's actually as simple, and you can see I got the whole unit out now, but you just squeeze on these two sides. Give it a pull. Well, again, one-handed. Everything's better one-handed, right, fellas?
Lift it out now. Getting hurt.
Oh, and yeah. Showtime. Let's do this. You just saw me push back these springs and release these little threads here. And I'm going to have to figure out how to remove that from the housing here. But you can see this guy gets pretty limp here because now he's more or less disconnected. Looks like there are four screws down here, or nuts, I should say. I'm guessing there's one right here. I just can't see it right now. So I'll get a socket. And they're painted in there. So this, guessing, is original. And we'll see if we can get this up. Get the new guy in its place. But yeah, look at that, pretty cool. Okie dokie, here goes nothing. I think we're working with a 10 mil nut. Let's see if it wants to come out. That was not much of a fight, so here's hoping I didn't just break my car. This is about to get real here, folks. Less 10 years of Lego wasted. We should be about ready to release this bad boy. Bad boy bingo. Marker. Okay. So that's free of that. Now we just gotta figure out how these guys come loose. Okay. A little squeeze, a little lift. Let's see if we can do that again. One. Definitely the squeezes help. Oh, yeah, it's all about the squeeze. One of my favorite sayings is the juice worth the squeeze. I don't know the answer all the time, but here it is. Let's see what we can
get. Yep.
Yep. Yep, we officially have a car that won't go. Alrighty, so here's the big moment. Moment of truth. As to whether or not this really is a match for match. Should have sandbagged and test fit this earlier, but that wouldn't be any fun for the video, would it? Okay, let's see. Scooch back a little bit. Eureka, as I believe they say in some parts of the world. This down and insert these guys. You can see this green unit here. That is a stabilizer for the purposes of, I guess, finding true metal. I'm sure there's probably a more real technical term for that, but that's the starting place, let's say. So that's where we're going to start with it, naturally. See if I can reach over here. I'm quietly confident I'm not have to worry about torque specs for this. That sounds torquey enough. I'm sure you're hearing lots of wonderful me crawling over leather noises. All right, let's give that a little bit. A little bit more love back here. Yes. And then we'll press that down in there. And that just naturally wants to go into its home, I believe. This guy needs a little help. There you go. And same again here. And then release these little knobbies so it can lock. So let's take this off and see what happens next. Well, would you know it? Something tells me we got a short shifter in play. Yep. So there it is, the twist tie is on. It's not the zip tie I was provided with. Let's just say we didn't get along. Okay, so the throw, a little bit of guesstimation going on, but 7.25 in first gear. Oops, sorry, I should show you that so you know I'm not cheating. That's the 3.5. So 3.75 inches. I think that's less than before, but honestly, it's been a long day and I don't remember. So I'm sure that video 10 minutes ago would have been a little bit more memorable to you. At least that's my hope. All right, folks, be memorable, be well. We'll check in soon.